Hi everybody, this is Chris Kaplan with Christina's Collection, and today we're going to make this beautiful set that is going to teach us how to watercolor with Wonder Crayons or Marvelous Markers from Stampin Up. Let's get started by getting our Regal Rose cardstock, 6 by 11 inches, and score them at 1, 5, 6, and 10 inches on the landscape side, and 1 inch on both sides on the portrait side. Fold it with using your bone folder and use a sticky strip to put the box together. I'm using the tape runner just for the matter of time, but you want the box to be strong enough to hold your cards. This is just like a pizza box. Okay, after stamping your first image, you're gonna apply some of the Wonder Crayon in certain areas where you are going to pull the color from using your blender pen. In this case, I'm using the yo-yo yellow, and I'm going to use the tempting turquoise for the bow and the only orange for the peak and the legs. So as you can see, I'm skipping the chest and the face of the duck because I'm pretending that the light is coming on this side and hitting the duck that way. So that part is going to be a little lighter. It's going to be color, but lighter. All right. The next step will be grab your blender pen and with small circles, start blending the color. At the same time that you are blending, the blender pen is catching the color that you, the crayon that is on the dock. And that is going to help you to color the lighter part where the light is hitting. Or that we are pretending that the light is hitting. All right. Once you get it, you can do just small strokes. And be careful with the chest and the face. You don't want to touch it without wiping your pen. So you wipe it a little bit with your cloth or on your paper, and then you can start coloring the parts that are supposed to be a little lighter. And as you can see, they are still yellow, but lighter. Very light. And that gives you the impression that the light is hitting there. If you see a real, let's say, a doll or a ceramic dog, and you put it against the light, it will be that same effect. Now we're using the blue, and we do the same. Put a little bit of crayon in certain spots where we're gonna pull it with a blender pen. Pull the color, I mean. Or take the color from. Okay, now the blender pens, you can do family colors, or you can do one pen for all the blues, one pen for all the oranges, and as long as you don't mix blues with yellows or blues with greens, you're fine. Okay, you're doing the same, pulling the color from where you put it at first. And if you need a little extra color in certain spots, you can use a Marvelous marker. In this case, is the Tempting Turquoise again. And remember that Stampin' Up colors are all matching. So just apply a little bit, the same way you did it with a crayon. And as you can see, you can still pull it with the blender pen because the Marvelous markers are water-based. There's another way to catch the ink with a blender pen, and that is taking the ink from the stamp, from the ink pad. This is another way that what you just saw. I'm taking the ink from the crayon, straight from the crayon with the water pen. I'm sorry, the crayon was in front of the camera. You just rub the blender pen against the crayon and you catch the blender pen will catch the ink. You do exactly the same, pretending the light is on this side, and you put a little bit of darker on the left and then pull it towards your hand. Okay. Now the background. You see those lines that I'm making with the crayon? Well, they will disappear because I'm going to blend them with the blender pen. Just the small circles, and do the same that you did with the whole picture, with the whole stamp image. All right, once you're done, just mount it on your Bermuda Bay cardstock, which is 3 1/4 by 3 1/4. And by the way, the watercolor paper is 3 by 3. These are 3 by 3 note cards. I'm sorry, this measurements that I just gave you are for the box. For the cards, the watercolor is 2 1/2 by 2 1/2, and the Bermuda Bay is 2 3/4 by 2 3/4. I'm so sorry. This is the next image, and we're using the close to cocoa, certainly celery, lovely lilac, and yo-yo yellow. And we're doing the same technique on the leaves. You'll see that I'm grabbing the color from the crayon because the area is very small. With the rest of the pod, you can do what you did with the dock. Okay. Now in this case, I'm using the marker. You see, I paint with a marker on the lines, and then I pull the ink from the marker. Remember that the marker is water-based, so it's easy. And if you need to fill the color, you don't want to rub the paper too much because it will crumble and it will be ruined. So if you need more color, just add a little crayon. In this case, I'm using crayon again with small circles, and I mount the images the same way I did it with the dog. And now we have the 4 cards. See, certainly celery, pretty in pink, and Bermuda Bay are the cardstock colors. All the Bermuda Bays are to mat the images, and then certainly celery and the pretty pink are the card bases. Okay, and the second part of this video, we will decorate the box that we just made, and we will be done. Visit my blog, Christina's Collection, for more information, to sign up for the classes, and it is christinascollection.typepad.com. And you can see a lot of ideas there. Thank you for watching. See you soon. Bye-bye.